Hello, people. Salut les gens. Welcome. Jeltes here. Hope you. Oh. Damn it. Oh, it disappeared. Hope you all are doing good today. A bit of the forest. First things first, I chose this spot here to build, and we're gonna go get the modern axe to get stuff done faster. So, yeah. I think I'm just gonna. Right now, probably show you the way I took. While I'm talking to you, so you just have to keep the ocean on your left. This is the fastest, easiest way to find the cave that will lead you to the modern axe, which is pretty much at the entrance, and where you just need to beat up a couple of monsters to get it. So I'm just going to show you where's the cave in question, and yeah. I felt like playing this game a bit. It's been through a lot, and wanted to test it out. So I'm gonna skip the first 10 days or so, start building, and then I'll get back to you on my progress. First things first, the modern axe, which I'm showing you right now, and then we'll go get the map and the compass and stuff. So yeah. I'm gonna start building, and I'll get back to you in about 10 days or so. Here we go, guys. And we are back. Another day of survival in this nice little yacht. So let me pick up the usual. Couple of pictures here, interesting pictures. I don't know if they're gonna show them. Yes, they are, of a teddy bear on the boat, apparently. The four-legged monster. Which we won't see because I have my axe. Let me pick up this cloth. I enjoy playing without the HUD as much as I can. You can't always. I mentioned it before, but yeah. Oh, he won't look at the carton because I already seen it and this I already picked up. Okay. Ooh, it's a nice little day. I'm not getting too seasick. So as you can see, the construction... the construction has gone well, if I can say. I now learned a lot. Like I mentioned, haven't played this game in quite some time. I think, like, actually I'm starting to understand the building, the custom building things. I didn't know what C was for, and that it could do automatically for you perfectly nice squared stuff. So my house is kind of crooked because my foundation is kind of crooked, so the whole thing is crooked, but that's okay. It's just a first base, probably will be more. I made this like kind of quick escape route right here, so I could, you know, kind of run towards the water and towards the boat in case of trouble, which happens often. I noticed, so let me just show you a bit here. Oops, clicked too fast. Been surviving for 13 days. I noticed that it's on day 10 around there that the four-legged creatures start to come out and bug you, and the, you know, zombies or, you know, wild humans, crazy humans start to get a bit harder. Around 10 days. I thought it was later than that, but no. For me, anyways, that's when it happened. So I'm pretty. I crafted not everything, but almost, you know, I got a lot of stuff. I didn't go and loot anything else that I've looted before, which is the modern axe. I've crafted everything else. Found this in the one of the villages, but other than that, I didn't go into any caves. I just concentrated on looting what I could around, surviving, crafting, as you can see, and building. So I got pretty much everything, I think, you know. Not everything, but almost. Missing a couple stuff. And here's the... As you can see, I'm a kind of a square type of guy. Not exactly square, but yeah, square type of guy. So yeah, now I know how to avoid all that. But yeah, so that's locked from the... outside, and because I put the door on the wrong side, obviously. I might change that around eventually, but Yeah, so the other one will be on the good side. I just won't come in this door. This is just like an emergency, or because there's a lot of fighting. All the fighting goes around here. But yeah, so it was just to show you the small progression here. And yeah, as soon as I go loot that cave to go get the map and the compass, I'll get back to you and finish a bit of the building here, especially the roof. And then we'll get to that cave over there. So yeah, see you in a bit, guys. I'm gonna go back, get back to my building. Okay, so it's been about 2 weeks. The building's getting, the progress is accelerating. Yeah, so I'm enjoying these stats, which I don't think are correctly working right now, but it's survival stuff, which I really enjoy. Like I said, it's been about 2 days. Apparently I'm infected, so I need to eat this. And I won't be infected anymore. There we go. I'm not infected anymore. So yeah, I got my ghillie suit on. And I did the fence all around. I did the main, finished the main building. Didn't do the roof yet. Just checking these notes out as we go. And last night, all hell broke loose. They're coming. There's not only weird mutants and, if I may say, and a double-legged monster. Now there's another tougher double-legged monsters. There's mutants, or, you know, whatever you want to call them. Others. I like calling them, referring them like on Lost, because they are others. There are others on the island, and they want you off and want to kill you and eat you, apparently. So they're like the others in Lost. But yeah, so since all hell broke loose last night, I've decided to go get the katana right now. So that's where I'm bringing you. And I'll finish the construction once I have the katana. And we're also going to go get the compass and the map. So I suggest you do that early on. I waited a bit because I wanted to concentrate on the building. And the reason you want to get the modern axe really fast is because it's the quickest way to bring down trees is with the modern axe. And everybody knows that you're going to chop a whole lot of trees in this game. So you want to get it done as more efficiently as possible, which is, and you know, win some time. And that the modern axe is the answer for that. So I suggest you get that as fast as possible, the as well as the map, so because it reveals itself while you're exploring, and the compass for some help. But then again, you also have the flags to go around stuff. So I'm gonna get in this cave and go get the katana right away. I think I'm gonna try to raise the brightness a bit, and you guys can leave me a comment and tell me if you enjoy it more with the brightness a bit higher, or the gamma, or whatever. Okay, so you don't want to light your light right away. Now, if I remember correctly, I haven't played this game in a while, so that's why I wanted to do this, these videos. I might do 2-3 or so. And, you know, except for doing the couple of videos playing an hour here and there, I haven't really concentrated for some time. With the house I just built and the 2 weeks that just passed, I now know a bit more of what's going on with this game. And I think I'm heading the right way. Yeah, I think it's this way. Anyway, I remember I had to, you had to keep a right. Always keep a right. I'm gonna light the hatchet because I think it's gonna get a bit more interesting right now. And if I remember correctly, you gotta fight a bit here. I'm gonna try to crouch and make my way behind them. Oh, but there's babies that, yeah, the babies will attack me, but that's okay. I'm gonna get up to this guy and, oh, there's some up there. I'm still gonna take my free shot. Hey! Crouching technique really works efficiently. I'm surprised those guys didn't jump yet. There you go. Stay away, please. Stay away. You too. Oh. You too. So I want to get rid of them because we're going to have to pass back through that. I don't know if you guys can see them. They're way up there. Sleeping, I guess. I don't know if it's because I came in crouching, but anyways. Stay up there, guys. It's all fine by me. I'm not sure if this is new. I never noticed. that passenger before. Okay, let's get these ready just in case. Now, if I remember correctly, yeah, I want to jump on top of here. Yeah, it's the same thing going left or right here, but it's just, yeah, there we go. A small tiny shortcut to get to the Alibaba cave, cavern, or treasures. Is that money that I saw before there? Yeah, I think there's gonna be a bunch of money where I'm going anyways. I think this is, yeah, this is the way I remember now. It's coming back to me. Here we are. Nice! Nice! Look at all this loot. Awesome. The katana. Now, guys, things will be otherwise. I also noticed that, like, the last time I really played at this game, it must have been around where, when they came out with the possibility of killing the turtles to get water with their carapace, or their, you know, I think that's the last time I was playing seriously, so it's been quite some time. I noticed that he swings way faster, so the game's a bit easier and a bit more reasonable, I would say, because the guy swings way easier, which means you, yeah, I want to find, there's a flashlight somewhere in here as well. There we go, this is the place. Let's drink as much as we can, because we won't be able to carry it all. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, I think the flashlight and something else is behind here. There we go. Got the flashlight. So at this spawn, you can get the flashlight and you can get the katana. And we're good. We have all our stuff. Alright. Yeah, those are, you know, really things you want. The katana, the modern axe, and the map are the three, I would say, one of, for me anyways, like the main things. You need to explore, you need to be able to kill everything, and you need to be able to get some, cut some trees down to be able to build. A little picture here. There we go. And now let's head back. I bet you on my way back, not sure, but those guys hanging on the tree, hanging on the ceiling will jump down. We'll see here. Just gotta find my way back. So I kept a right going down, so you keep a left going back up. Okay, should be around here. Let's concentrate here, because I think there's three of them, and probably the babies will spawn back, so it's gonna be a lot of action. Might be rougher on the way back, on the way out. Here we are. Guys, you're still hanging. You guys hanging out? I'm not gonna hang with you, I'm just gonna be on my way. I'm gonna stay crouch and hope that they don't come down. We should be good. Oh, don't wake up your buddies! I'm trying to not wake them up or anything. Stay crouch, and we're good. Look at that. Awesome. You guys can wake up now. I'm running away. Huh. They really don't care. I'm wondering. They might be bugged there. Ouch. Listen, buddy. I'm gonna try. I'll probably jump if I kill this. Nope. Okay, guys, well, thank you. I had a good time. I'm gonna leave you now. So, yeah. Let's get out of here. I'm not looking for trouble, because you never know. One or two bad swings, and, you know, you could die. You gotta watch out in this game, but I enjoy that. The thing I don't enjoy in this game, or, you know, find a bit too easy, and would be better if it was, or, you know, if would add to the survival challenge, and this is a survival-based game, would be, first of all, I like the, it's funny how in games, you'll always get some stuff that you love in games, and some stuff that you love in other games, and you like them to put them together to make one, but that's just the way the world works, you know, not everybody thinks like you, or likes the stuff you like, so, that's just the way it works, but I'd love it if it be like in The Long Dark, where you would only have one life. So you would. Did I get this guy in my list? I think I did. I didn't. I have to come back in here anyways and check everything out and check that this list. I got a couple of them down already. As you can see, they get marked off as soon as you find them. And that's one point of the game. You gotta find all the passengers, including especially your kid. Okay, so let's get out of here. Like I was saying, I'd prefer if you could actually, you would only have one life. So you would die once, they'd capture you, bring you back in the caves, and then if you die again, it's game over. But what happens is most people just reload their game. But that would be awesome if you die a second time, your save game erases. Now, I know there's a lot of investments in each life and everything, all the buildings, all the trees that you cut down, all the everything and everything, but that's, you know, the way I would like it anyways. Kind of like The Long Dark. On the other hand, hey you, come here. Were you crazy just passing in front of me like that? Yeah, I need a lot of hide for different reasons. I especially would like to find some deers, lizards and deers. Rabbits were okay for now, but lizards and deers mostly. Let me get out my spear here. I would love The Long Dark to adapt what they've adapt sleeping-wise. You can't sleep as much as you want in this game. You can only sleep at nighttime or once a certain, you know, and it's not necessarily at nighttime. It's just you gotta pass some time before you can go sleep again, which is realistic, which I love. I really love The Long Dark to do that because it's not realistic otherwise. Why? That's bug. There we go. I should be able to hit him on the first shot or. The hell? Okay, there's some guys around. Oh, duck. Passing by. Just don't make any noise. Hey, rabbit. That's. I should be able to. There we go. Okay, luckily they didn't notice me. That's cool. Let's try to find a deer while we're at it. I'd love for the Long Dark to adapt to the. Because it's true, in real life, if you slept 12 hours, you can't go sleep another 6. Good luck with that, you know? But anyways, like I said before, you know, it's some things you'd love it. But I love how they're, you know, bringing more and more survival aspects to this game. It's really appreciated. And yeah, the way I'm gonna play my life is just as I told you. I use the save spots as checkpoints, like you normally do, but I refuse to reload my game if I died twice. I haven't got caught in once yet, so I've never died, so I still have my, you know, kind of two lives deal thing. And as soon as I get caught and brought back in the caves, that will be my first one, and as soon as they kill me again, I'll call it a day, count my days survival, and that will be that. Because if not, you can just reload and, you know, infinitely, and, you know, after that, if you say I've survived 10 or 50 days, it doesn't change much. There we go. Here you go, buddy. Just a bit higher there. Oh, too high. Damn it. Okay, I want my spear back. Give me my spear back. There we go. Okay, I got it back. Went over there. Stop. Best way to notice something moving is to stop moving yourself. My spear isn't doing what I want it to do right now. I want it to be. There we go. Not like that, though. I want to be able to throw it, and he's. That animation's not good. I want you to hold it down more so I can raise it and throw it. There we go. That's what I want. And of course, the deer's gone at this point. Oh well. It was meant to be. You were meant to survive. I don't know where he went. It's a pretty game, and I really feel like I'm in the forest, you know? It's really. Okay, so we'll try to find another one on the way. We're going to the other cave, like I mentioned before. We're gonna get the map and the compass, so that we're all set for exploring, defending ourselves, and going into other caves and stuff. The flags are now fixed. They're they've been with the patch, which brings you not much, but a what's it called? You can craft yourself a armor made of bone, basically. So they added that. And you can also, and they fixed the flags and a bunch of other things, but it wasn't much of a, there wasn't much else in the update. That just occurred this week. Oh, there we go, a bit higher. Beam. Oh, that scream though. Okay, I got my hide, got the meat. Don't need the head right now, got my spear back, that's the most important. And we're good, apparently there's nobody home. So, I'm gonna... I built a house here, so... No, I think we're gonna leave you alone. I built this house because the flags wouldn't work anymore, so... I built it quickly and could find my way around. Now they do work, though. So we're gonna quickly save. So we save with our Cantana now. And we're good. Hey, buddy! I need your feathers, sorry! It's like in the Long Dark, you need the feathers to make the arrows. That's one thing that's stopping me from using the bow right now. Sorry, buddy, but I needed your feathers. It's because gathering feathers takes time, and I just didn't get around to it. I just want to check if I go back up here, if I sit over here, if another crow's gonna come and sit down, so I can get his feathers as well. Apparently not. I scared him off. I'm so mean. Poor little guy. Just for 2-3 feathers, was it really worth it? I think the best way to... This game is gore anyways. I mean, it's the gorest game you'll... Survival game you'll play. Nah, I decided. You're gonna live, buddy. We have other things to do right now anyways. But yeah, so... Where's the house... Okay, there's a house where with a cave entrance, and that, and right at the entrance, once you're in the cave, you can find the map and the compass right away. So, yeah, we're gonna do that, and then head back home, finish our roof, and then we'll do some exploring. Okay, let's head in. Hey, buddy. Let's head into the darkness. But we won't be in here for that much time, that long of a time, because like I mentioned, it should be right around here. If you guys are interested to know, there's another passenger. Hey, buddy. I'm gonna light this one, so I have my other one ready to light on fire, just in case. So it should be... around here somewhere, if I remember correctly, on the left here. Is there another? Yeah, on the right here, you'll just find a little room with suitcases, if I remember. Yeah, that's it. So you got a lot of cocktail Molotovs in here and suitcases. That's about it. And on the left, when you start heading down, what do you see? I just want to check if I missed... No, okay. What you see right here is a body on the floor, and he has a bunch of stuff. He has awesome stuff. So, a little chocolate bar is here. How many do I have? Because you can only carry certain amounts of everything, so you always want to use them. There's the map. We now have the map, and look! Started to explore already. That's awesome. I love that idea. It's the best. The more you explore, the more you get. That's the way it works. I love it. And our compass. Can't see much here, sorry. We're not gonna keep going down here. We're just gonna head back out. We'll keep that for another day. We're gonna head back home, put down some of the stuff we found, stock our loot. Hopefully. We're not out yet. We didn't make it back yet. You never know. But yeah. We now have The katana, the compass, and the map. We're all set. Cool. Village looks pretty abandoned, guys. Now, I know it's mostly a cave map. That's what I heard. But I heard that it kind of works for the... I want to say the you know, the normal world, not the cave world, the island world. So I just, that's what I wanted to check out, how it, if it really works. Or I think it, what happens is it only, it's gonna indicate, yeah, I live towards the south. Now I know that much. I think it only indicates like the cave entrance. On top of the, you know, on the island, it's going to show you where there's some... Oh, I want to get some of these. Put them in my little bag here. Stock them a bit. Always useful. You can also do paint with them. I want to find some black ones as well. I already have a couple of them to make... because you can make normal arrows, fire arrows, and... Hey, guys. What are you guys doing? I want my hands... my hand to stick out normally so I can aim. Come on, put away the compass, please. They're running away, man. He won't put it away. There we go. Okay. We're good. See, that's your aim, the hand. Right there. Oh, beam. And we're good. Okay, we're bringing back some food as well tonight. Gonna make some beef jerky. And I wanted a carpet made of deer skin. So we got it all. We're good. We're all set. Let's head back home. And now that the flags... See, I have no flags to... The only... The white flag that... Where my house is over there is actually not a white is actually not a spot where you can sleep and stuff. I have none. I use the boat, and that's what I recommend. Use the boat to get stuff done, and you can sleep and save in there. And if you ever run into trouble, you just jump in the water and go back to the boat. That's what I do, and that's how I got stuff done. Ouch! Ouch! Didn't mean to do that. Okay, so I stole everything without too much trouble. Suckers, thank you for your stuff, thank you for the map, thank you for the compass, and I'll take care of all your stuff, guys, don't worry. Oh. Shit, speaking of the others, just keep running here. I'm gonna light this just in case, because they do run fast. I'm just gonna run by, guys, don't mind me, I'm going... I won't get the stuff back, forget it. Bring it on, guys! Damn it! Here we go! Okay, I burnt you, I hit you, and you're still alive! Here we go! There we go. I might as well use my katana now that I have it. Teach you guys a lesson. I'm gonna keep it, it's mine, you hear? You too! There we go, that's taken care of. Oh! Oh! How many of you? Did you guys bring your whole family or something? Oh my god! Okay, there's a bunch of them. Die! Woohoo! That was a close one, actually. I'm stuck here. Never know. I think I hear another one. I think there's another one. Oh, that rabbit scared the living daylights out of me, if I may say. Okay, let's head back home. And yeah, it's been like over 30 minutes, so I'm ready. I'm going to have to call it a video. Hope you guys enjoyed this time together. I'm going to head back home in my little boat, because I still haven't had a bed in my big house for now. And yeah, hope you guys enjoyed this small video to get this time together. This might have helped you, maybe not. Hopefully it entertained you, and I'm hoping to see you on the next one. Share the love, guys. You know what to do if you want to help me and see more. Thank you for being here. I really appreciate it, guys. And see you on the next The Forest Adventure. Take care. Bye-bye. and Jelta's out.